Have you ever felt overwhelmed by a situation that you ordinarily would feel fine doing? That happens to many people daily. And sometimes there's nothing you can do about it. One evening in Sacramento, California, a waiter waited on a customer who would end up doing something completely unexpected. It was a busy night and orders needed to be taken. Drinks needed to get made, but everything stopped after this moment. Keep watching to find out how this story unravels and learn the astonishing twist that awaits ahead. Hello, wonderful people. I'm Scott Leffler for WonderBot. And here is... Waiter dashes after customer once he reads the note left on bill. Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. If you've ever been or currently are a waiter or waitress, then you know this next statement is true. Waiting on tables isn't an easy job. You have to work long hours, your pay's not that high, and sometimes rude customers can ruin your day. One night in Sacramento, a waiter noticed one customer acting strangely. The man left the restaurant in a rushed manner, but not before leaving a note on the table. After reading it, the waiter rushed out to chase the customer. This odd happening took place on a warm Friday evening. The nice weather brought out a ton of customers to the restaurant, and only one waiter was covering the patio, David Fabia. Fabia is a hardworking man dedicated to his job, but this night made him feel somewhat overwhelmed. A customer even pointed out that Fabia could use some assistance to handle the mass amount of people that filed into the diner. He still somehow kept up. Before we dive right into the story, it's important to know some background information about Fabia. He's a 31-year-old dad living in Roseville, California. Roseville's in the Sacramento metropolitan area. Fabia had two jobs, one as a waiter at House of Oliver Wine Bar, and another strictly to make ends meet. Unfortunately, a lot of parents know that feeling of working two places out of necessity, not desire. Fabia had to provide for his children as best as he could. The funny thing about the story is that Fabia wasn't even a waiter. The man was a bartender at House of Oliver, giving the people the spirits they requested with pizzazz. Because it was a busy night, he got roped into working as a waiter. House of Oliver was short-staffed, so every employee had to chip in as best they could. It didn't take long for the father to become overwhelmed after serving a few customers. Some can keep up with the blind confidence for a short while, but eventually it wears off. That's what happened with Fabia after he did an excellent job for a short amount of time. Thanks to being short on staff, there wasn't anyone that could help him, and so he had it all by himself. The harsh part is that Fabia had recently finished working his other job, so he was exhausted. The night seemed like it was only going to get worse. Little did Fabia know, his life was about to change for the better. One customer would end up affecting Fabia's life remarkably and unexpectedly. Fabia never saw anything like this coming his way. The customer we're speaking of is Stephen Burr. Fabia didn't notice Burr in the restaurant because it was so busy. There was no way that he'd be able to pay attention to or acknowledge Burr, especially since he had a job to do he didn't usually do. Fabia worked many years in the service industry up until this point in his life. He found that there were good days and bad days, and although this wasn't his dream job, he knew it was for his family. Fabia knew this business would have him dealing with many different types of people and that he had to expect the unexpected. Thing is, Burr was like no one Fabia had ever served before in his life. Unfortunately, Americans working in the service industry don't get paid that well. What they depend on is tips, so they have to be as polite and friendly as they can while serving to get proper tips. Tipping is natural now in American culture. Every waiter, waitress, and bartender can attest to that, as they depend on the extra money a customer provides to them. Fabia was someone who needed as much as he could get, but whether the tips were helpful or not depended on the customer. That night where Fabia had to fill in as a waiter filled him with doubts and worries. He had a lot on his plate, so he worried if he could do the job correctly. Thoughts of, is he being kind enough? Is everyone getting their proper order? And was he leaving an excellent first impression ran through his mind. Many of the customers had their focus on the food and enjoying the evening. Burr had his sights set on Fabia, watching him like an eagle. A few hours went by and the place became a little less hectic, thanks to many customers leaving for the night. That's when Burr asked for his bill so he could be on his way. Fabia went to print the check and bring it to Burr, but walked away right after bringing it to serve new customers. Upon returning to Burr's table, he found that he had left already without notifying his waiter. Many times, customers would use their card to pay for the bill, so Fabia would have to bring them the card machine. This wasn't the case this time around with Burr. In other cases, people would pay in cash but stick around to wait for their change. Burr didn't fall into any of those categories, as the gentleman departed right after receiving the bill. Once Fabia examined the check closer, he couldn't believe what he saw. Burr's bill was nearly $200. It was evident that he didn't mind how much food would cost him that night as he splurged on the drinks and eatery. To be more exact, the bill came to $191.39, and he decided to pay by check. The only thing was, the amount Burr left ended up being twice the amount of the original amount. Fabia thought this was a mistake, but he noticed a note written on the bill. Shocked, Fabia read the note Burr left behind, and it read, "We're young, we're both serving." Bill left a tip that equaled the same amount of the original bill. Fabia was going to take home a lot of cash that night. Fabia was quite speechless when it came to the situation. He might have needed that money more than others, but he still needed to make sure that it was for him. That's when he dashed out to look for Burr. Thankfully, it didn't take long for Fabia to track down Burr. When he found him leaving the restaurant, he asked him why he left such a gracious tip. As it turned out, Burr was only 24 years old, studying at Sacramento State, while working an unpaid internship too. That only made the gesture even more incredible. When he heard Fabia ask if it was a mistake, he replied that it hadn't been one at all. Burr and Fabia began to talk for a bit, and it became apparent why the former left such a generous tip. Burr knew the struggle that Fabia had endured because he was a server too. When giving an interview to CBS, he revealed that people don't appreciate the services that waiters provide unless they've been in their shoes. Burr also could empathize with Fabia because he knew what it was like to work a busy shift alone. Burr had no clue about how Fabia lived his life. There was also a popular tip the bill challenge going around. That wasn't the reasoning behind this kind tip either. Burr was a simple man who enjoyed the service he received from Fabia. He wanted to reward the man who kindly served him with a healthy tip. Fabia's level of surprise was off the charts because people usually aren't that kind these days. There are still some good people out there, though. The reasoning behind Burr's massive bill might make more sense after hearing this. He was at the restaurant that night to celebrate finishing his senior year of college with his friends. For many years, Burr worked hard to earn some cash, so he felt it was his time to give something back. It's always nice to see those in better situations help those who may need a hand. Burr saw Fabia working hard, so giving him an extra tip was the least he could do. Local news stations wanted to interview Fabia about the fateful night. He used this opportunity to thank Burr for the extreme kindness he showed a fellow hard-working server, and for proving that friendly people still exist. The two of them had never met once in their lives. Still, Burr decided to lend a helping hand with a large sum of money for the tip. That extra loot could have helped Burr as well, but he wanted Fabia to have it. While it may be something of common knowledge to those who work in the service industry need tips to help buff their low wages, it's not as common as you might expect. Some folks don't leave any amount of tip, let alone how much Burr left behind. An accepted percentage that people should do is 15-20% of the total amount of the bill. Statistics show that as much as 40% of Americans either do less than that or leave nothing at all. The biggest concern that service workers face is a labor law called tipped minimum wage. It's not a pleasant law, but one that's in play for all servers out there. Website minimumwage.org reports, California's normal state minimum wage is $12 per hour. California labor law allows tipped employees to be paid a lower cash wage than the standard California minimum wage by their employers. If they were able to make the same money that other workers receive, then the issue wouldn't be that bad. Many feel that the system isn't appropriate. They've asked for appropriate wages for all those working in the service industry because relying on tips isn't an ideal way to make a living for yourself. As things changed, it would mean a more stable and trusted employment structure for millions of folks all over the nation. It would be sensational if this happened because not everyone is as kind as Burr when it comes to tipping. We've talked thoroughly about how Burr is a kind man who gave his waiter an immaculate tip, and how he's a stand-up guy for this act of kindness. The thing is, it's more than just generosity. Burr was in a comfortable place financially, so he could leave that massive tip that thanked Fabia for all his dedication. While this was an extreme act of kindness, it also showcased a side of humility from Burr that anyone can appreciate. Burr didn't want any type of credit for what he did. It was a deed he did out of the kindness of his heart. Burr believed that Fabia genuinely deserved that extra $200. He departed the restaurant so rapidly because he didn't want any praise. The only reason we know about the story is thanks to Fabia tracking down Burr before he left. What it boils down to is that we can all learn a thing or two from Burr. We hear all the time about how wealthy people take part in generous donations. They'll donate to various charitable causes multiple times with large amounts. For this, they get praised, as it should be. The sad part is, not everyone does good deeds out of the kindness of their hearts. Some might donate to make themselves look good in the eyes of others. They might also do it to make themselves feel better or to get some credit. Some people believe in karma, while others don't. Karma says that any deed done, whether good or bad, will come back around in some shape or form. That's why we should always treat people how we want them to treat us. Some folks don't even think about karma, but do things that will eventually become vital for their futures without even knowing it. Burr didn't consider karma when he did this. He only wanted to help. The most crucial lesson we can take away from this story is never to give up. Fabia had a rough night that evening at the job, but he still carried on like a champ. While it was apparent that Fabia needed something to lift his spirits, he never expected to receive anything like that from a customer. Imagine if he had left earlier, told his manager that he needed help. He might not have gotten that extra money. If you're ever going through something, stay the course. You never know what could happen.